Graditissima sorpresa qui a Muro Leccese, dove incontriamo il campione 2010 della World Series 3.5, Mikhail Aleshin, a cui chiediamo ovviamente cosa sta facendo in questo favoloso cartodromo pugliese e soprattutto, viste e considerate le voci che lo riguardano sempre più vicino al mondo del Formula 1, cosa c'è di vero?
Well, so first of all, I'm on this track because I have four young drivers which is driving after under my support and the support program which calls our formula, which the head of this program is me and my father, and we already support around 10 drivers overall. So I'm here just to come and help them, just to teach them something, because definitely they need the support on such a strong level of go-karts. Attention to me becoming a Formula 1 driver for next year, I wouldn't be hurrying too much, you know, because at the moment we just need to work, and we have a big opportunities and a good possibility to be there next year. We have correct proposals from a couple of good teams, so at the moment we just need to we basically need to work on it hard, so I think it's quite possible, I hope.
Mikhail, sei stato protagonista di una grandissima stagione nella World Series 3.5 e protagonista soprattutto di grandissime, gran belle battaglie tanto con Daniel Ricciardo, ora terzo pilota della Toro Rosso, quanto anche con l'argentino Esteban Guerrieri, ma una su tutte è stata proprio l'ultima battaglia con Daniel Ricciardo negli ultimissimi giri di Barcellona. Per cortesia, puoi farci un po' da telecronista di quel grandissimo evento, di quel grandissimo sorpasso su Daniel Ricciardo?
Actually, it was a really hard race for me because the qualifier didn't went well for me. I was only P5 and my main concurrent Daniel was P2. So it was quite hard, but after a couple of laps, I start to gain him, and then Daniel Zamperi went off, Greg Mansell went off, and then I was very close to Daniel, and then I needed to come in the pits. After the pits, I was quite fast, so I catched him very easy. But after that, I start to have a problem with the dirt on my visor, so I couldn't see anything, and that's why I pulled away a little bit from me. And after I cleaned my visor with the hands and inside as well on the straight was quite hard, but it was nothing to do, you know. I knew that or I need to do it now or never. So then I came close to him, and around maybe 3-4 corners before my overtake we were fighting, and in the exit of one of corner 7. I just overtake him from the outside. I know it's this place is a little bit tricky. It's a little bit unusual place to overtake, but I just, that's how it happened, really. I just thought that maybe it's a good idea, you know.
Sei il campione 2010 della World Series, ma cosa consiglierebbe Mikhail Aleshin a un pilota proveniente dalla Formula 3? World Series o GP2?
From the next year, World Series. From next year, sorry, GP2 will have a new car. It will be a brand new car and more horsepower with engine. So I think it will be actually quite fast car. It probably will be constantly driving, maybe on the same level as Hispania, you know, HRT Formula 1 team. So my guess is definitely for next year is probably GP2 is better than World Series. But this year, GP2 has more power definitely, but with aerodynamical part, I wouldn't say it's a good car really. But for next year, it's completely different story. And I know the people who already drove it, and they say it's fantastic. So it's fantastic. But for me, World Series was great this year. Screaming, but the ghosts aren't real.